sir. Please be with us, always giving your messages and talking about Swami. We feel it like, because you are blessed with the Swami's everything. We think that Anil Kumar Garu is so much blessed and so much loved by Swami. As if you talk, we feel very much and we are so inspired. That's why we are coming to you, sir. Please always convey your messages and guide us as our guru, teacher, master, professor and everything. I request you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you very much for all your appreciation. Believe me or not, I am here in Prashanti for that purpose only. If I am physically attracted by Baba, if my connection with Baba is with his physical form alone, I would have left this place. If my understanding of Baba is only that physical body, I would have left long back. If I am selfish to have closeness with him, if I am selfish to have all the chances of translating his talks, I would have left long back. Soon after he left the body, I would have left this place. But I am here, why? I want to be useful to devotees. I want to talk to people. I am available to everybody. But to my bad luck, or I do not know that Swami has not yet willed that way, people are not making use of his services. I am available. I am always available. Yes. And I can say, the only attraction for Anil Kumar to live, to breathe, is only to spread message. I have no other interest to live in life. The whole family is doing in its own way, blessed by him. And there's no point in holding on to the family and to selfishness, to self-interest. I never had those things in my prime of youth itself. Believe me or not, I never asked anything Swami to give me. I never wrote any letter to Swami to give me that or complaining against anybody. I never asked for anything for myself, nor reported against anybody. So my only desire is to live for Sai. So I am available. So it is for the people to make use of my presence here. Thank you very much.
Sir, that's why I am here. You believe it or not. From 1919 to 9, this time, I am here. Why? Because of you, sir. You believe it or not. Because you inspired me. You guided me. You teach me. Either in this form or in my guru's form, in my mind. So, sir, it's the time. You are the so important person who can spread Swami's message direct to people. You can only take, because I don't know other people though. You said, Narayan Bhatt, one Narayan Bhatt I know. Others I don't know. One Anil Kumar Garu I know. Others I don't know. How can I talk with about them? Yes, just like we realize it's Swami, we can talk about him, not others. That's why I told him, anyone, he said, you can come here and pray. Oh, it's enough for me. I will come whenever I can. Now, today we are one. Tomorrow we may be all. After, in that way, when Swami started, he is the only one. As a human being, he started everything. No? Okkadugu, just one step will lead other steps. Whether I am wrong or right, I don't know. But what a year, coming from inside, I feel very much, sir, because nowadays, it's after all, 1.5 year it passed like that, second year also completing why people are behaving in that old way? That's the main thing. We have to change our attitudes, our everything. Then everything will be okay. I hope Swami will do. Always he is in the form of us. He is making us to think. He is making us to move. I know that. But we have to move most and more. Dedicating ourselves. Half if we dedicate, then all human body will follow that. That's why.
Sir, sir, we are very happy to meet with you again. Thank you very much. We are interested, sir, in knowing your recent talk to students especially and to people in general with the festivity New Year 2013. What exactly are you sharing now in this New Year with the students and devotees and non-devotees in general, please?
Sai Ram, thank you, Miguel, for the keen interest you have shown in this matter. Every year, coinciding with the New Year celebration, we have alumni meet of Sri Sathya educational institutions. As they meet, they plan for the next year course of action and review the past year work as well. And they make good presentations. They also have a music program and Sai Symphony brass band by the old students. This is what they do every year on the New Year's Day. This year, the organizers requested me to address in the evening session for about 10 minutes. There was also another speaker by the name Dr. Srinivas, a distinguished alumnus, a cardiologist, staying now at Visakhapatnam. I happen to be the second speaker. I shared my views with the entire gathering openly. In the first instance, I mentioned the immense love of Bhagwan for his students. I recall an incident when Bhagwan was waiting at the door to receive students whose arrival was delayed because of some technical fault in the bus in which they were traveling. Swami did not have his lunch, anything whatsoever, waiting for his children. After their arrival, Swami said, "How can I take anything without my children here?" It is a clear proof of his love for his students. I also brought back to my memory another instance. It was the breakfast time in Kodaikanal. All of us were seated, expecting Swami any moment. But he came 15 minutes late. Looking at everybody, Baba said, "There's one boy who is sick there. I made porridge for him. I made him partake that porridge I made. And I came down now. All children are important to me. He is also my child. God cares for his children. He makes porridge and goes up, feeds him and comes back. What a wonderful sight it is. What an excellent proof of his divine love for his students." Like that I was recalling certain instances of Swami's love for his students. It is one of the Deepavali days, occasions, Deepavali, in Bangalore, where I happened to serve there as the principal of a college. On that holy day, Swami called one boy, "Come here." And he said, "Here are a bunch of letters I received. You pick up any letter you want, open that, and take it whatever is there inside." The boy opened the cover. He picked up just a random cover from the bunch of letters. And that cover contained 500 rupee note. Swami said, "You take it." And Swami commented, "This boy is not going to the canteen for the last 2 to 3 days as he did not have enough of money. He wrote to his father to send him money order and he did not receive money till now. Therefore, I had to give him money." And then looked at the boy and said, "Boy, you asked for 500 rupees, so I give 500. And you asked for 2,000, I would have given 2,000. You only asked for 500, what can I do?" He laughed and laughed. There is another instance. It was a drama staged by students, and one student did not perform well. It was not up to the mark. And that boy was feeling very sad. He called that boy, "You have done very well. All the dialogues came out of your heart. Other fellows, they just acted as an art, but there is no heart. Your action is full of heart." That's how he defended that boy. Because Swami never ever discourages anybody. He always encourages. That is the instance I said. Like this, in my talk, the first couple of minutes are structured to let the audience know the immense divine love of Bhagwan for his students. And the next couple of minutes I spent on Sai philosophy of education. What is the Sai education of philosophy? To sum up or to summarize, his education philosophy is to establish universal peace. Peace in the universe. To dispel all narrow-mindedness, parochial, regional, linguistic feelings. It is equality, cooperation, equanimity. These are the qualities of a Sai student. And education is important for this purpose. I quoted Swami's poem at the meeting, his own composition, and rendered it to English. Vishwasanti chekurpu vidamunerpi. That which teaches you to establish world peace. Sankuchita bhava molanella samaya chesi. That which dispels all kinds of narrow-mindedness, regionalism, factionalism, linguistic chauvinism, all these things we know. Aikamachyamu sagajivanadikamu samatha nirputakare sarasavija. Unity and the life of cooperation and equality. These are the principles of Sai philosophy of education, which I reminded the gathering that morning. There is another poem which I also quoted. Sadgunandulu Sadbuddhi Sathya Nivati Bhakti Krama Sikshana Kartavya Palanambu Nirpunadi Vijaya Vijati Adi Nervavalayu Vijati Nervavalayu. What is education? It is the one that inculcates virtues, good sense of discrimination, adherence to truth, devotion, discipline and duty. These are the six principles of Sai philosophy of education. I mentioned this also in the course of the talk. Then I switched on to the role of alumni today. Till now, whatever we have done is tolerated. All our mistakes have been excused. All our lapses have been ignored because of the physical form of Bhagwan amidst us. Now that there is no physical form, we have got to be careful more than before. We often say, quote Swami, saying, my life is my message. We quote that. But Swami said so. But our people gave another interpretation. Swami, let our life be your message. Good. When Swami said, my life is my message, we will say, let our life be your message. It means that our life should reflect the glory and the perfection of the life of Bhagavan, Sri Satsaiva. What I said was, people will notice whether your life is according to his message or not. People will notice. Public will watch. Devotees will question. If there is anything wrong, they will say, is that the way how you should behave? Is that the way how you should speak? So we are answerable. We are accountable to the general public hereafter, particularly now, when there is no physical form of Bhagavan Sri Satsai Baba amongst us. Then I told another point. We say Sai students. You all boys call yourself Sai students. But I look at this way. It is not for you to declare that you are a Sai student. It is not for you to say that you are a Sai student. It is okay till now. But hereafter, society will judge whether you are a true Sai student or not. We should say, based on your character, integrity, honesty, behavior, we should say, here is a boy with all the qualities expected of him. He is the Sai student. So Sai student is not a title to acquire. It is not a degree to claim. But it is one that is given to you based on your character and skills. That's what he said. By the time it was 10 minutes over, I got a slip reminding me that it's time to wind down. With these views, I concluded my talk. But sir, now I can share with you some more viewpoints. every Sai student, I wish, should be an institution for himself. Sai student is not an individual, but is an institution. Why? He can start a Sai center wherever he goes. He can sing and see that bhajans go on uninterruptedly. He can speak on Sai message. He can teach in Balavikas. Like that, every old student should be an institution to carry Swami message onward and forward. That's what I said. So it is for us to say that you are Sai students and not for you to declare or publicize. That's what I said. So this particular program should continue forever and ever, the Sai students, so that it continue to inspire the generations to come. These are the words I said to them on first evening in my talk. Thank you, Miguel, for your interest.
Sir, we have more time now to share with you, and we have plenty of interest about many questions, please. If you don't mind, what happened with newcomers, new people that are coming to Sathya Sai Baba? Because until now, we were talking about devotees, non-devotees, but in your own example, you have shared this last week with non-devotees more than 1 lakh. The message of Baba, people that never before have been as devotees. For future, what must we think about our behavior with these people that not know Swami as physical form?
Thank you. It is really a very genuine question, a very sincere question. There are very many newcomers into our fold. What program have we on hand to share with them? To tell you the truth, as a responsible body, as an organization, there is no definite program specially designed for newcomers. But if you ask me, I have got my own plan. I'm sure at least you care to hear me, if not everybody. I would ask these newcomers to assemble after bhajan session in one of the halls there. Talk to them about Baba. Make them speak about their own experiences with Baba. Like that, absorb them into our fold and get myself absorbed into their field of operation. Thus, I get interconnected with the newcomers, what I do. I get connected with them. And the second thing I would do is, I would show them Swami DVDs, Swami's lectures, different festivals. And third thing I would do is that I would take them around Prashanti, the museum, hospital, educational institutions. Finally, I would arrange interviews for them. Some of the students can talk to them. They can talk to students. Some of them can talk to senior devotees. They will also share their experiences. By this, newcomers should have a special package D so as to understand Swami and experience Swami. Thank you.
Some more questions, sir, appears when we talk about the time that is coming after Swami passed away. This is something different that before when we talk about religions, because Swami also talk about the union, the unity of religions. Then, not in the Hinduism, because not hierarchy, but now, how must be guided the message of Swami, because there is an organization that has newcomers, an institution that are spreading and showing to the general public the message of Swami. How must we go on in these structures?
Thank you. It's a lovely question indeed. I appreciate your question. Because unity of religions is the essence of Bhagavan's teaching and avatar. I'm not a policy maker. I have no say in the decision making. I am not in the administration. But I have few ideas to share with you. Those who are willing can adopt them at their centers. The Sai symbol carries different religions. Sathya Sai badge, Sathya Sai organization carries a symbol. That symbol has so many religions. Christianity, Hinduism, Islam, Buddhism, Sikhism. These symbols are there in our organization flag. I personally feel we are not doing justice to Swami's ideas. My question is this: how many of us know about Quran? Zero. How many of us know about Buddhism? Zero. How many of us know about Sikhism? Zero. We know little about Hinduism, having been born here. But we say unity of religions. I don't think it's a correct thing to say that. I recommend this way. One day, we can have a talk on Hinduism and Hindu prayers. Second day, talk on Christianity and Christian prayers. Third day, a talk on Buddhism and Buddhistic prayers. So each day for one religion, followed by their mode of procedure, their mode of worship, their mode of sadhana, so that all religions are given equal importance. People will come to know that all religions are equal to Swami. So I recommend that every Sai center should make a deep study of different religions, at least these five, as shown in the banner of such organization. At present, nothing is done in this regard. I don't think that anybody is paying attention to that. Balakas is doing in a small way. A prayer song may convey the spirit to some extent, but not in-depth study of the religion. Thank you.
Can I share one question?
Yes.
Then, are you in certain way proposing that some representation of another
religion
must be
there
in the same Mosamiti
center
or whatever is the
unit? Yes, I would say this. Supposing today, Sunday is the holy day, Sabbath day for Christians. Let the Sunday be for Christians. I will ask some Christian father to speak on Christianity. Then I will speak on Christianity, comparing with Baba teachings. Then there will be few Christian bhajans, followed by Sai bhajans and Mangala Harati. Friday is important for Muslims. I'll call one of the Muslims, Maulvis, from Masjid, to speak on Islam. Then I'll speak, comparing Islamic principles with Bhagwan Sri Sathya Baba. Then there'll be recitation from Quran, followed by Sai Bhajans and Mangala Harati. Like that, we can call experts from different religions and one of us to correlate with Sai teachings and end with that particular religious prayers followed by Sai Bhajans and Mangala Harati. That's how I look at it.
Naturally, there are not any kind of passport or any kind of card for devotee or no devotee. This is the new time in this new year, probably for considering. We are not in a society where we can make some club from, with Swami, no property in the message of Swami.
Baba clearly said, at the time of the first international conference held in Bombay, that Sai is no separate religion. Sai is no sect. Baba further said, all names are mine, all forms are mine. Therefore, Sai is not a separate religion. It is not a separate sect. All religions are his. Yes, strengthened every religion. He has given additional strength to every religion, wanted every one of us to follow our own religion. Therefore, to make Sai a religion, to say that religion of Sai is mine, that is all nonsense. Sai is nobody's property. Sai is no religion. Nobody has a common right over him. Nobody can patent him. All belong to him. Some know that, some do not know that. But all belong to him. So there is no question of non-devotees anywhere. Thank you.
Sai Ram sir, thank you very much for your comprehension and your talk. And if you wish to share something more in this new year to general public, because we are talking now for general public, and this is the reason, because probably you have attended this last week and a very, very cloudy session, and is your idea in the future, no, to attend all kind of invitations that are with people that are interested in the spiritual path. No?
I'm glad that you have put this question, and I thank Saiwisdom team to have arranged this interview this morning. That has given me ample scope to share my views with everybody. And as this website is uploads this morning's interview, everybody will come to know what I feel about it. My personal opinion. This new year, right from this new year, let us understand the following things. Number one, today is different from yesterday. Yesterday in the sense when Swami was in our midst. Today when Swami is no longer in our midst, in his physical form. What is the difference between yesterday and today? We should understand. Secondly, Sai activity, some sevadal activity is not enough. Let us understand Sai mission, and we have to take up the activity with a vision. Sai mission with a vision is possible if we are missionaries. So these are the three important. In Sai mission, we should turn ourselves as Sai missionaries with a vision so that the organization will serve in the long run. Next point is, let us be aware of the fact that we need a new presentation. We need something novel, something new, something fresh, something unique. The old repetitive method is no longer valid. Youth are having very high expectations on us. So let's also try to devise certain methods to modernize our activities, to update our data, to see that we fit into the contemporary world. Our presentations, our talks, our budgets, our activities must be appropriate to the times that we live in. That is the point I want. And the next thing is, let us know what is happening all over India. What is happening in Orissa? What is happening in Rajasthan? What is happening in Andhra? We should know that. That is not known to everybody. Everybody thinks that he is doing a good job. Yes, you are doing a good job. But by knowing others, you can do a better job. So this kind of link, interlink, is necessary. Feedback on every activity is most important. Finally, to train a second line of leadership is of the urgent need. Thank you.
Professor, excuse me if I go a little deeper in one of your answers, but I understand that you are asking for some kind of information because you miss some kind of information what is happening there. Sai movement, internationally speaking.
This is because we don't have any single report summarizing all the activities at the global level. Each country has got its own bulletin. Each state has got its own newsletter. But I feel that there should be a common general report comprising international activities and the national activities, so that I come to know what is happening in the outside world.
Thank you very much, sir. I don't know if you are interested in sharing something more, or the audience here want to know something particularly. But if not, we are very grateful to you to share in this new year message, and we hope that happiness comes to everybody. Inside and outside organization, inside devotees and non-devotees, because we are all followers and we are all spiritual seekers. Thank you, sir.
Finally, I express my great sense of gratitude and satisfaction to Saiwisdom team and Mr. Miguel, who has put all these questions and could elicit information from me. My hearty greetings, a happy new year to all the viewers of SaiWisdom.com website. Thank you very much.
Anybody wants to ask some question, please? You want some question? That's a good point. We can hear this.
Okay.
You were talking about international information. I'm thinking of a second type of sanatana sarathi or something in that respect.
Oh, well, nobody prevents them from releasing such a report. They can make any report like that with the activities at the global level and circulate. Nobody prevents them from doing it. The only thing is, they might not have applied their mind in this direction.
Okay. And also, Mahika, I didn't touch my chapter. Sir,
అంటే ఒక పర్సనల్ ఇది మీరు నేను నారాయణ భట్ గారి యొక్క మిషన్ చదివాను తర్వాత ఇప్పుడు మీరు చెప్పారు మిషనరీ లైక్ దట్ వారు కూడా అదే ఎక్స్ప్రెస్ చేస్తున్నారు అప్పట్లో అంటే నేను దానికి అనుకునేది మీరు చెప్పినట్లుగా పీపుల్ ఇక్కడికి రావడం కాదు స్వామి మిషన్ పీపుల్ దగ్గరికి వెళ్ళాలి మీరు అంటే ఎట్లా అంటే ఇప్పుడు క్రీస్తు విషయం తీసుకున్నా అప్పుడు ఎవరు అక్కడికి పోలేదు సువార్త ప్రకటింపబడింది అట్లా సులభం జరిగింది మీరు ఆ కోరినట్లుగా అంత లెవెల్కి జరగాలంటే మనుషులు ఇక్కడికి రావడం లెక్క కాదు మీ మెసేజ్ మాత్రం చాలా ఫాస్ట్గా చాలా మంది ముందుకు వచ్చి వెళ్లాల్సిన పరిస్థితి అని నేను భావిస్తున్నాను దీన్ని మీరు ఇందాక చెప్పిన సమాధానమే ఇంకా విపులంగా చెప్పను
Our question is this. It is true that we share these views with you all. And she says that there is a need for more number of volunteers to work in this direction. And she also cites an example of Narayan Bhatt, a Mudanahalli, who started this institution. The vision by Z. My humble submission to you is there are many Narayan Bhatts in such an organization. If you go to Godavari districts, there are many people who are working like that. If you go to North India, there are many people working like that, many Narayan Bhatts. But the only difference is Narayan Bhatt is lucky enough to have behind him like-minded people. He is doubly lucky to have committed brahmacharis, the celibates, around him. Therefore, he could become such a great man and organize mighty institutions. But here, no one is totally free. No one can completely devote their time for the organization. We are all limited. Sunday devotees are Thursday devotees. We are not like, we don't spend all the time for Bhagavan. As in Mudanahalli. So what I say is, we should also have a plan to see that people are trained. And these trained people will expand the organization in due course of time. Thank you. Swami, what did he do? He got the massive water project of hundreds of crores inaugurated by the Prime Minister of India. He got the university library inaugurated by K.C. Pant, the then minister. He invited President of India, Prime Minister of India, as the chief guest of honor for convocation of the university. Why did Baba do that? When these big people come, they will come and see what is happening here. When these dignitaries come here, they will be followed by officials and the media. The media will give wide coverage in its papers because the dignitary is here. And all the officers that follow him, these dignitaries, will also come to know what is happening here. That should be followed in the whole of the organization. But it's not happening. I'm very unhappy to say this. Today, we have activities inaugurated by conveners and the presidents of the organization. Is it wrong? Such an organization activity, how can that be inaugurated by such an organization man? No use. Come on, invite some minister, invite some educationist. Invite some prominent man so that you know what is happening here. and immediately assemble and give wide coverage. Then watch this.
Sri Sathya Sai Baba, Sri Sathya Sai Baba, Sri Sathya Sai Baba. Sri Sathya Sai Baba, Sri Sathya Sai Baba, Sri Sathya Sai Baba. Thank you.
Saiwisdom.